Hey friends, welcome to another video. Hope you're having a great day. So friends, as you all know that RBI has issued a circular to all of the banks in India who are dealing with cryptocurrency exchanges. So they have asked all the banks to stop relationship with any cryptocurrency exchange, and they have given an ultimatum for 3 months. So after 3 months, we cannot convert cryptocurrency in Indian rupees. And the last date is 5th July. And against that decision, there were many petitions in high courts, supreme courts and lower courts. And there was a hearing of one of the case yesterday. And we were curious to know, you know, what is going to be the decision. However, the hearing got pushed back to July. If you see this news, breaking news, RBI versus cryptocurrency, Supreme Court pushes back date of hearing in July. So if you see this tweet from Crypto Kanoon, so if you are not following Crypto Kanoon, please go ahead and follow. These are experts, you know, people, group of people who are expert in law and in crypto both. So they understand the space in better manner. They know the law, and they know the people's fundamental right. So let a copy of the petition be served on Mr. Kuldeep S. Parihar, learned counsel appearing for the RBI. So his guy from RBI is going to attend this case on behalf of RBI. Here is a Twitter from Crypto Kanoon. Crypto exchanges which are planning to approach different high courts against RBI circulars should be mindful of the Supreme Court's order. If RBI files such application and SC allows, it petitions filed pending in high courts may be ordered to be transferred before Supreme Court. So what will happen? Any petitions, you know, pending in lower court or high court will be transferred to Supreme Court. So there will be hearing in Supreme Court only. Yeah, so the interesting question, I would say the million dollar question is, the last date is 5th July, but the hearing is on 20th July. So what will happen between those time? Will we be able to continue to trade the way we are trading after 5th July, as you know, we have hearing on 20th, or this is going to be a ban? So it's very interesting to see, guys. I think we'll be able to trade as there is a hearing on 20th July, and there is no there is uncertainty of about this decision. So we really don't know what will happen in the court. So it might be, you know, might be the case, you know, court can ask, okay, or maybe RBI can issue a circular, or maybe can tweet that, okay, we can go ahead and continue to have the relationship, you know, the way we had between banks and cryptocurrency exchanges. So again, it's a speculation. It's very interesting to see what will happen. So what I think, what is my personal take about this scenario, guys? I think there could be two situations, two scenarios. Supreme Court can ask RBI to hold on their decision as long as Indian government comes up with some sort of regulation or regulatory framework, or Indian government takes final call whether the cryptocurrency is legal or not. So because, as you know, there is a committee here in Indian government. There are some experts who are evaluating this space and trying to put a regulation, regulatory framework, so that we can trade or invest. So RBI, I mean Supreme Court, will say that, I might say that, you know, I'm not sure, again I'm speculating, just to wait for the Indian government decision on cryptocurrency. And if that happens, I think there will be stay on this RBI circular, and this will be the biggest relief for the cryptocurrency investors. Second scenario could be that this case, you know, keeps on pushing or maybe postponing to the next date, and till then, maybe, you know, the court can ask RBI to hold on to their decision. So in both cases, there could be a stay. Again, I'm an optimistic person and I think positive, so I think it will be great relief for us. So let's see, guys, what happens next. It's very interesting. Keep your eye open and keep this news on radar. Keep reading, you know, what happens in regards to this case. Moving on, guys, I think all the assets will be tokenized. You know, I have mentioned this many times on my channel, that in next 5 years or 10 years, all the assets will be tokenized entire world will be tokenized, and it will be very hard to avoid this revolution. We cannot control it, we cannot stop it. Whether it is India or any powerful country, I think nobody can stop this revolution, because it is so unique, it is so unstoppable, because you know it's decentralized in nature. We really can't control or can't kill the technology, kill the evolution. So yeah, India should understand this, and maybe, you know, I know government, because it is against establishment, it is against centralization. So I really think that they don't like it, but if they really believe in democracy and if they really believe in, you know, people's welfare, I think they have to come up with some sort of regulation or favorable decision, because the entire world is watching and looking at these countries like India or Pakistan or Nepal or Bangladesh, who are really trying to kill the innovation. If you look at some other developing countries who think out of the box, like Japan, South Korea, Australia, so these countries will definitely have an upper hand, an advantage, you know, in this technology. Because this kind of revolution happens every 20-25 years, and I think this is the biggest revolution after internet. So what internet did to the communication, in similar fashion, cryptocurrency will do to the money, to the finance. Entire monetary policy will be disrupted. So yeah, this is very big, guys. This is very big. And we are early adopters, and we'll be able to have you know, upper hand. So moving on, guys, I'm looking on some of the news from India, and I can see there are some possible reasons why these governments are really trying to ban the cryptocurrency trade. So there are so many scams, there are so many Ponzi schemes going on in India. I have made few videos, you know, on scammy projects like Healthy Coin or ATC Coin. So basically they are multi-level marketing. So what they do, basically they do multi-level marketing. They have, like, you know, what you call chit funds. So they used to do this in traditional way when there was no blockchain, when there was no Bitcoin boom. But now they have got the name, the Bitcoin or the blockchain. So in the name of blockchain and Bitcoin, they're really trying to loot people. So they think that they have got the money printing machine. So they're making any shitty tokens, any coins, you know, and you know, they are saying, okay, you take my coin, this is the next Bitcoin, this is the next big thing, you will make 50 times gain. Look at the Healthy Coin guy, my guys. He has said, okay, you have to buy a coin at 1 rupee and it will be listed at 65 rupees. So they are saying that you will earn 65 times gain on your investment. So this is completely lie, and this looks really, really fake. So these kind of multi-level marketers and Ponzi scam masters are really making our lives difficult, you know, the real investors' life difficult. And this is happening. I was reading some news. If you look at here, guys, there is a person called Manish Kasana, and he was the MD of LCC Coin, and he made 250 crore scam. He made 250 crore fraud. So here is the petition against this guy, and they have written it to the Narendra Modi. So this is going to government, and they are really getting an excuse, a strong reason to enforce, to ban the cryptocurrency. Let me read this, you know, some important points. So here it is. Scammer Manish Kasana, MD LCC Coin, 250 crore scam within 4 months. We want refund. So as you all have heard that name of Bitcoin, now the day so many scams are going on in country on the name of Bitcoin and other cryptocurrency, and so many people getting involved and starting their own crypto, even they do not know the sea of crypto. That's very true, guys. They really don't understand the technology. They really don't know how blockchain works, what is blockchain, what is the underlying technology behind blockchain, and they are making any shit tokens like Healthy Tokens or ATC or TCC. It's very serious matter. They are working like RBI, So they are basically printing money. They are basically issuing currencies, coin. If you see the currency notes that are also issuing cryptocurrency or digital tokens in a large number, like billions of tokens, which has zero under asset value. So they do not have any utility, you know, any usage of the token. See here that this guy made billions of tokens, and that was initially launched at 1 rupee. But unfortunately, people were investing their hard earned money and buying so-called digital token. It is so shocking to know that how they will get profit when another person buy this token at high price. Owner has no responsibility. He has given just token, and they suppose all money of investors their own money. So they think, okay, it's all of the money, you know, of investors. It is their money. In the same way, a person, Manish Kasana, MD, LCC Coin, start a new crypto. That name is Litecoin Classic on 16 September. Not registered company in India. And he started with 1 rupees at the time of launching. So many people invested their hard money in this coin because Kasana has promised to all investors that he will do better and the rate of coin will go high and will get profit. On the time of launching of this Ponzi plan, the minimum package of buying coins were 5,000 coin and maximum no limit. And this plan, almost 125,000 people have joined. So these many people are, you know, joined. And after getting 50 crore, he invested this amount in Bitcoin. So basically, he collected 50 crore in the name of shit coins, in the name of LCC, which has no underlying value. And he invested that 50 crore in Bitcoin and made 250 crore out of it. So in the other hand, if we suppose the scammer did not invested that 50 crore in Bitcoin, then also he has done the scam of 50 crore rupees. So yeah, at least he has done the scam of 50 crore if he would not have invested in Bitcoin. So after that, he has done a scam of 46 Bitcoin in this owner. So he is challenging the judiciary of country. He said many times to the investor, do whatever you want, go for police, go for court. I'm not afraid of anyone. He do not get any update regarding the process. So basically, he is trying to threaten the investors that nobody can do anything. But now I think he got caught, and I think he is in jail now. There is another guy called Amit Bhardwaj. He is already landed in jail. So I think, guys, the people like Healthy Coin or Subhash Javeria or Manish Kasana or Amit Bhardwaj, they are really making bad names for entire crypto space, and their place is jail. So eventually they should go to jail, and I really believe that this guy also will land in jail, maybe in a year or two, or maybe in months. So, and also, I'm really afraid of people, you know, who are promoting such schemes, many big YouTubers, and this will happen to them as well. There will be legal action against those YouTubers who are promoting these shitty scams. This has happened in BitConnect case. There were, I think, 4 or 5 YouTubers who got convicted in BitConnect case, and I think there is trial going on, and eventually they are also in jail. So yes, you should understand, you are an investor. If you're investing your money, do not invest in MLM, multi-level marketing coin, or Ponzi coin, because this is your money and you are responsible for it. Do not trust anybody, any YouTuber or any person. Trust yourself before making any investment decision. There is another news, guys. Indian origin man indicted in multi-million dollar cryptocurrency scam. So this guy got jailed for 65 years. So I really appreciate, I'm really happy for this, guys. These sort of people should land in jail, and there should be strong action against these people. So yes, guys, this is it for now. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please subscribe, and please share my videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.